Hi there, my name is Sam Correia. I'm from Attleboro, Massachusetts, and I recently completed my graduate degree in Library and Information Science from Simmons University in Boston. This summer, I worked in the Professional Learning and Outreach Initiatives Division to create a resource for teachers using primary sources from the library's online digital collections. This resource provides digital, ready-to-use materials for educators. With my research, I wanted to answer some questions. Why are primary sources by and about women important in science classrooms? How can we better highlight the achievements of women in science in a way that emphasizes their work and not just their gender identities? How do we conduct research about women when so much of their histories have been erased? I searched through images, manuscripts, books, and videos on the Library of Congress's website to find related materials. I also searched through the digitized newspapers found in Chronicling America. By using search terms such as computer, biologist, woman scientist, inventor, and astronomer, I was able to parse through the available digitized materials. A list of names of women who have made contributions to science was also created and used to cross-reference in my searches. There are some realities about conducting research on women's history. Women's accomplishments are often told in the context of the other people in their lives, such as, in this case, male scientists. In the fields of science and technology, women were often not allowed to participate, and when they were, assumptions were often made about their abilities based on their gender. And in some cases, male scientists would often receive the credit for the work done by their female colleagues. This primary source set highlights themes such as women in wartime, collaborative efforts between scientists, and the everyday aspects of science. Here are some resources that I found that will be included in the building of a primary source set. For example, this oral history interview was conducted with a woman who was a codebreaker in World War II. And this newspaper article here shows a woman working to program a large computer in the 1950s. Engaging in scientific discovery does not just take place in the lab, but can take place anywhere, including at home, at work, and with family. In this photo, students are working together on a science experiment. My project is not intended to serve as a complete history, but instead provides a broad overview of the topic by highlighting items for teachers. This project has allowed me to consider the ways in which educational resources can provide multiple perspectives and stories for students to learn from. Thank you.